ask you the question number 8. By how much is 7486 centimeter greater than 8597 millimeter? Give your answer in meters. That means both you have to see the both. First of all, the main thing is that you have to first of all you have to check the unit. How much is 7486 centimeter greater than 8597 millimeter? Which one is greater? How much greater? That one you have to find. So without converting, don't do like this. That this one minus this one. If you will do, what you will get? That one it will be answer. Don't do like this. Okay. First of all, you have to do what? Convert the units. Read the questions properly. Give your answers in meter. That means answer should be in meter. So what you will do? First of all, you convert the centimeter to meter. This one also is converted to centimeter, millimeter to meter. So both the numbers are in meter. This one is centimeter, this one is centimeter. You convert into meter. So one, two numbers you have got, na meter. This one also in meter, and this one also in meter. So after that, do the subtraction. While do the subtraction. So if you do the subtraction, then you will get how much, how much difference is there, and which are is which one is greater and greater by the, another one, how much greater, that one you will get, and after that you match the options. Okay, that means first of all you convert the centimeter to meter and this millimeter to meter. So there one number you will get, in this case also one number. So now do the subtraction. Which one is bigger, from the bigger to smaller, you do the subtraction. After doing the subtraction, you will get the answer. Okay, one can of juice contain 330 millimeters. One can, juice can is there now, that can contain 330 millimeters of juice. How many liters of juice is there in a pack of dozen cans? One can contain this much millimeter. So one dozen of cans will be how much? One dozen means 12. That means 12 can will contain how much? Will depend in any method. Okay. The product of two decimal is 136.369. If one of them is 2.65, other will be what? Suppose the two number, this one is one number, multiplication, this one is one number. If you do the multiplication, you are getting this number 136.369. And the one number it is given 2.65 it is given. So you have to find this one. So this one I don't know. So that's for doing the calculation I have done is it as a x. Okay, see here this one. Product of x and this two point, another number is given in the question. If after doing the multiplication, the result is this one. So you need to find this x. So x I have kept in one side. So this number it will come to the denominator. Okay. So now see, numerator in three decimal places, denominator in two decimal places. So numerator is bigger. So 3 minus 2, 1. That means numerator will be one decimal places and denominator will be free. So in one decimal place I have written 136.369 and denominator is a decimal point free. Now apply the divide process. How will you divide? While dividing, you forget about the decimal point. Simply you need to divide. After dividing, according to the your dividend, you have to adjust the quotient. Okay, 51.46 you will get. Okay, 11 number. A bookcase is 2.38 meter tall and height of each shelf is 34 centimeter. So this one, suppose this is your one bookshelf. Okay, this is one bookshelf. That bookshelf total height is given 2.38 centimeter, and in this bookshelf's shelves will be there. So each shelf's your height is given how much? 34 centimeter. So like this, how many shelves will be there for this much length? So what you have to do? 2.38 divided by this one, but here your unit is given in centimeter. This is the main trick. This is your centimeter is given, it is meter it is given. So first of all you convert the centimeter to meter, or convert this meter to centimeter, then after you do the division. Okay, that's why this question is given, to make you confused. Okay, 12 number. See, a party of 12 people went to a restaurant. They ordered a meal of 30 rupees, 36.6 each, but five of them had forgotten to bring money. In order to settle the bill, how much more did the 15 people need to pay? Total number of people are there in the restaurant is 20. They have together they have gone in a restaurant. Suppose someone's birthday party is there. So 20 people has gone to the restaurant. So they have ordered some meal. So the cost of each meal is 36.60. That means each one have to pay this much. But five people have forgot to bring the wallet. So if five people have forget, then their bill should be paid by remaining how much people? 15 people. That means these five people's bills are divided into 15 people's. Isn't it or not? 20 people have went to the restaurant. They have ordered something. The cost of each ordered item is 36.60. Okay. So if you multiply 36.60 into 20, then you will get a total bill. Total bill is your 732. Okay. So that means each people has to pay this much and total bill is your this much. But five people have forget to bring the wallet. So if they have forget, their bill has to pay by someone else in their group. So that five people's bills are divided to how many? If five people have forgot, how many remaining are there amongst 50 to 20? 15 people are there. That means these bills are being divided by 15 people. So first of all, you need to count what is the bill of these five people. 5 into 36.60. so five in this much bill, this much is the cost of five people's food. So that means this much extra this 15 people have to pay. So that means 183 is divided by how many people? 15 people. So what you have to do? 183 divided by 15, that means 12.2. that means this extra money this 15 people have to pay. Besides this 36.60, this 15 people have to pay extra 12.2 rupees each. Okay, then only their bill will be, this five people bill will be adjusted. Otherwise the restaurant owner will not allow them to go out now if they didn't pay their bills. Okay, so with this your half yearly course is complete. Hope you all have understood properly everything whatever I've explained. If you didn't understand, again you go through the videos, try to see the videos one, twice, thrice, then you will understand easily. On the main thing is that you have to note it down, whatever documents I have given, all the notes you have to write in your copy. Okay, in systematic order, one by one, like chapter wise I have given PT1, then after half yearly, like this you have to note it down in your copies. Okay.